everyone, it's Katrina. From ancient megalithic stones to finding lost treasures during quarantine, here are 10 archaeological discoveries you've probably never heard of. Number 10. The Crick Stone. Men Antol, also called the Crick Stone, is a series of small standing stones in Cornwall, England that likely date back somewhere between 3,500 and 4,000 years to the late Neolithic or Bronze Age. Its Cornish name means stone with a hole, which appropriately describes one of the monuments at the site. The original design of these megalithic remains is up for debate, but they were most likely once part of a big stone circle. Viewed together from a certain angle, the three upright granite stones that make up Men Antol look like the number 101, and there are more stones buried nearby. Each of the side stones are about 4 feet high. The middle stone is somewhat octagonal in shape and is 3.6 feet tall and 4.3 feet wide. Its circular hole in the middle is roughly 1.6 feet in diameter, and experts are unsure whether the hole is natural or man-made. Either is possible, but it is more likely that the hole was made on purpose and was aligned along the circumference of the circle to provide some type of lens or window into other worlds. According to local legend, if a woman passes through the hole backwards 7 times during a full moon, she will become pregnant, and if a child suffering from tuberculosis or rickets is passed through the stone, they will be cured. The stones at Men Antol have been rearranged over time and were most likely part of an extensive ritual or ceremonial complex. The Crick Stone is located near other ancient landmarks, including a Neolithic enclosure, Bronze Age barrow burials, and a stone circle called the Boscedon Nine Maidens. The only other stone with holes in Cornwall is a triangular formation known as the Tovan Hold Stone. These stones are surrounded by stories that they held magical powers that could cure the sick and protect against witchcraft, and perhaps even tell the future. Number 9. Child Amputee Burial. In an extremely rare discovery, archaeologists working on Indonesia's Alor Island found the 8,000-year-old burial of a legless and armless child. A recently published study detailing the remains describes how the people who buried the child removed their long leg bones and disposed of them elsewhere, and how a pigment called red ochre was painted onto the face as part of the burial ritual. Archaeologists have discovered other burials of people with missing arms and legs from the same time period in the region, including on the islands of Borneo, Java, and Flores, but this marks the first ever discovery of a child buried in such a manner, according to a statement from study lead Sofia Sampercarro. Child burials were seemingly rare until around 3,000 years ago, making the find especially valuable, as it stands to teach researchers more about how people of the early mid-Holocene epoch handled children's remains. Experts are unsure whether the child was a boy or a girl. Their bones resemble those of someone between 4 and 5 years old, but the child may have been malnourished and small for their age, as a dental analysis suggests they were a little older, perhaps between 6 and 8 years old. Another possibility is that the individual had a genetic condition called island dwarfism, which results from prolonged isolation. Generally speaking, the skeletons of these ancient hunter-gatherers tend to be unusually small, but beyond the theory of island dwarfism, researchers are kind of unsure why. Number 8. Ancient Dog Origins. Dogs have been our best friend for thousands of years, but the exact origins of modern domestic dogs and the nature of their relation to wolves are long-running mysteries to scientists. Actual solid proof remains elusive. In the process of their ongoing quest to learn more about where today's dogs come from, scientists recently conducted the most extensive study to date on ancient dog DNA. The findings, which were published in the journal Science, bring experts closer than ever to the answers they seek while also raising new questions about the evolution of domestic dogs. Scientists analyzed the genomes of 27 dogs, in addition to the 6 that were published before the study. In doing so, they determined that the origins of modern canines likely trace back to an extinct and yet unidentified group of wolves. A finding that not all experts agree with, but which is worth noting. The team also learned some more interesting facts, including that dogs had already spread worldwide by 11,000 years ago and consisted of 5 distinct lineages after initially being domesticated perhaps around 20,000 years ago. Shockingly, ancient dogs were more genetically diverse than those that exist today. Although scientists believe that dogs descended from wolves, none of their ancient wolf DNA survives, and dogs do not acquire wolf DNA even after crossbreeding with wolves. Experts are unsure why this is the case, although one theory suggests that dogs share such a close relationship with humans that evolution simply rejects their wild DNA. While some researchers hail the findings as more or less definitive proof of dogs evolving from a single wolf lineage, others are more cautious, or believe that modern dogs may have more than one point of origin. One mystery along these lines lies in how dogs spread so quickly around the globe, vastly superseding human expansion in comparable terms. For now, and perhaps indefinitely, there are many unanswered questions revolving around the beginnings of man's best friend, but this groundbreaking study brought scientists several steps closer than they've ever been. Number 7. Elite Viking Settlement. Thanks to radar technology, archaeologists have identified an elite Viking settlement and burial ground in southern Norway, dating back to sometime between 550 and 1050 AD, during the Nordic Iron Age. The site may have once served as a political and/or religious center for those who inhabited it, and is offering researchers a glimpse into Nordic society's transition from the Iron to the Viking Age. A recently published study in the journal Antiquity notes that the site contains one of the largest Iron Age burial mounds, and that a treasure trove of artifacts have been found there, including a Viking ship. The discoveries were made during routine excavations required by Norwegian law after the landowner applied for permission to build a drainage ditch on the property. Ground-penetrating radar technology revealed the existence of a significant archaeological site, enabling experts to investigate without digging. There was already an established history of three burial mounds being plowed at the site during the 19th century, but until recently, nobody seemed to know that there is a lot more to the property's history. The recent research showed that there were once 13 burial mounds on the land, with some measuring over 98 feet wide. Most were encircled by ditches and were used over several centuries during the Iron Age. Additionally, the site once contained four longhouses, the largest among them measuring 90 feet long. These structures were likely used as dining halls or ritualistic and religious centers. Number 6. Where did hoofed animals come from? Did you know that rhinos and horses originated in North America about 50 million years ago? Known as Hyraceus and Eohippus, they were quite different from the animals that we know today, but they all come from the same family, Perissodactyls. It includes horses, rhinos, and tapirs that all have hooves. But where did they come from? Turns out about 54 million years ago, there was a mysterious small hoofed animal called Cambytherium thewisi. A painstaking 15-year study recently wrapped up with a thorough description of Cambytherium, an extinct fossil family related to the modern-day group of hoofed animals. Researchers looked at 350 fossils that were found in an open-pit coal mine in modern-day Gujarat, India, and figured out where they fit in the family tree. Its members were more primitive than Perissodactyls, yet more specialized than those who came before them. First described in 2005, the extinct group that included Cambytherium branched off just before Perissodactyls evolved. Based on the fossils, researchers believe that Perissodactyls originated in or near India before dispersing elsewhere throughout the world. At the time, India was a separate continent, which ultimately drifted northward away from Madagascar and later collided with what is now Asia, forming the Himalayan Mountains, a process that began 50 million years ago and continues to this day. Finding an animal so close to the first Perissodactyls in prehistoric India is helping us to understand how these mammals spread all over the world. Number 5. Our prehistoric cousin. In 2018, archaeologists working in the Drimolen cave system near Johannesburg, South Africa, unearthed the 2-million-year-old skull of one of our earliest distant relatives, Paranthropus robustus. The skull belonged to a male and is the oldest and best-preserved example of the species. This large-toothed, small-brained cousin of Homo sapiens, aka us, modern humans, walked the earth alongside Homo erectus, our direct ancestor and a member of our family tree. Paleoanthropologist Angelina Lees says, "But these two vastly different species, Homo erectus with their relatively large brains and small teeth, and Paranthropus robustus with their relatively large teeth and small brains, represent divergent evolutionary experiments. While we were the lineage that won out in the end, 2 million years ago, the fossil record suggests that Paranthropus robustus was much more common than Homo erectus on the landscape. Paranthropus robustus existed from roughly 2 million years ago to 1.2 million years ago. The recently discovered skull was reconstructed from hundreds of pieces and represents a lineage that lasted for around 1 million years in South Africa, according to archaeologist Andy Harries. Based on its unusually small size compared to other, later examples, the skull suggests that the species evolved rapidly in response to climate change, perhaps over just tens of thousands of years. Ultimately, however, Paranthropus robustus appears to have succumbed to the effects of climate change, not as tough as they used to be. Number 4. Earliest twin burial. It's rare for archaeologists to discover prehistoric infant remains, let alone those belonging to twins. But it happened in 2005 at the Krems-Wachtburg archaeological site in Austria, where two male infants from an ancient hunter-gatherer society were discovered, and DNA evidence recently confirmed it as the oldest known twin burial. The pair were found with grave goods among the ruins of a settlement dating back up to 40,000 years. In the words of the researchers, the boys were embedded in red ochre, and they were placed next to each other in flexed positions facing east and with their skulls pointing north. One infant was adorned with 53 mammoth ivory beads, while the other was found with shells and a fox tooth. These items were likely either offerings to the gods or given to the dead for use in the afterlife, reflecting the early existence of religious or supernatural beliefs. Following the discovery, scientists extracted and analyzed DNA from the twin skulls. Their findings, which were published in the journal Nature, confirmed that the babies were male identical twins. They lived around 30,000 years ago, and one was likely between 6 and 7 months old when he died. This is the first time that twins from the Paleolithic era have been confirmed by DNA in the archaeological record. Number 3. Rare brick tombs. Construction workers in eastern China recently stumbled upon formations made from colorfully painted bricks. Suspecting that they had encountered an important historic structure, the team reported the discovery to local officials. As it turns out, they had found two rare 1,800-year-old tombs. Discovered in the modern-day city of Dezhou, one tomb measures 65 by 20 feet, while the other is 52 feet long and 13 feet wide. Their brick walls feature patterns painted in shades of red, black, white, and blue, which were extracted from natural resources, according to professional restorer Han Yongxing. The brick structures are painted with intricate murals. They were built side by side and likely belonged to an important family of elites from sometime between 20 and 225 AD, during the late Eastern Han Dynasty. Their social ranks were not low, explained researcher Chao Fang Cho, which told Pear Video, adding they could be regional officials, landlords, or powerful figures. The discovery of the tombs, along with a collection of grave goods, is helping experts to better understand the region's history. Number 2. New dinosaur species. Last year, a PhD candidate from Virginia Tech College of Science found fossilized bone fragments of a rat-like creature in the Petrified Forest National Park in Arizona. The fossils belong to a previously undiscovered species of cynodont, or stem mammal, a predecessor of modern mammals. Dating back some 220 million years, the creature, dubbed Cataegidodon venetus, offers an important look at the geography and environment at the time. In the words of lead study author and the fossil's discoverer, Ben Kligman, it also adds to evidence that humid climates played an important role in the early evolution of mammals and their closest relatives. Cataegidodon was living alongside dinosauromorphs and possibly early dinosaurs, and was possibly prey of these early dinosaurs and other predators like crocodilomorphs, small coyote-like quadrupedal predators related to living crocodiles. The discovery of a Cynodontia fossil is incredibly rare in North America, according to Kligman. At the time the recently identified specimen lived, what are now Texas and Arizona were situated near the equator as part of the supercontinent Pangaea, and the environment was lush and tropical. It likely would have looked like a small rat or a mouse, Kligman said. If you were to see it in person, you would think it is a mammal. He believes that there are more fossils from this time period in North America, and there are more new species waiting to be discovered. Number 1. Secret treasure. While working mostly in isolation on a restoration project at Oxburgh Hall in Oxborough, England during the ongoing pandemic, archaeologist Matthew Champion discovered a treasure trove of artifacts beneath the historic structure's floorboards. Not bad for a quarantine project. Champion was hired to work on the project after major structural problems were identified with Augsburg Hall's roof in 2016. Now a tourist attraction, the moated home was built by and once belonged to Sir Edmund Bedingfeld. Included among Champion's discoveries are 16th century clothing, Tudor books, and medieval manuscripts. While meticulously combing through the debris, he found a treasure trove of artifacts among two ancient rat's nests, including textile, shreds of early music, and pieces of printed and handwritten documents. But it was other workers who came across the two most valuable finds, a 600-year-old manuscript and a copy of the King's Psalms, a book dating back to 1568. The latter is one of two only known copies in existence, making it exceptionally rare. These objects contain so many clues which confirm the history of the house as the retreat of a devout Catholic family who retained their faith across the centuries. Russell Clement, general manager of Augsburg Hall, told CNN, "This is a building which is giving up its secrets slowly." Thanks for watching! Have you ever heard of any of these discoveries? Have you found anything fun during quarantine? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. See you in the next video. Bye!